Good morning, everyone. Today, my drug expert is about sulfasalazine. Introduction, the generic name is sulfasalazine. Brand name is azorphidine, azorphidine TN, SAS GS, SAS salazine.
See, your voice is very low.
Okay. Now it's good enough?
Now it's okay.
Last is 5-aminosalicylic acid derivatives. Sulfasalazine is used to treat rheumatoid arthritis, ulcerative colitis, and Crohn's disease. And also, sulfasalazine is the first-line treatment for rheumatoid arthritis and Crohn's disease. It's the first-line treatment for ulcerative colitis and rheumatoid arthritis. And I found out the table that's brand name and cost in India. You want me to explain one by one, sir? The brand name is Iwatotab sulfasalazine 500 mg. The company is Cadila. Packing of 10 tablets. The price is 62.61 rupees. And SAS tab is sulfasalazine 500 mg. Company is IPCA. The packing of 10 tablets is 35.50 rupees. And SAS DS tab is sulfasalazine 1000 mg. IPCA company, the packing of 10 tablets is 67.90 rupees, and Salazar EC tab sulfasalazine 500 rupees. Cadila company, packing of 10 is 67.41 rupees. Salazopurine tab, there is 500 mg. Okay, the same company, Valies. The packaging of 10 tablets is 41.42 rupees, and the packaging of 50 tablets is 190 rupees. And Sulfas tab sulfasalazine 500 mg is Jolly Healthcare. The packaging of 10 tablets is 120 rupees. And Sazo EN tab sulfasalazine 500 mg is Wallace, okay, company, and packaging of 10 tablets is 56.80 rupees. And Zemosol tab sulfasalazine 500 mg is there, and 1000 mg, and same company is Sun Pharma. The packaging of 10 tablets for 500 mg is 55 rupees, and for 1000 is 105. Administration is oral tablet. Normal tablet is 500 mg, and enteric coated delayed release tablet 500 mg and 1000 mg. Dosing. About other dosing, ulcerative colitis, 3 to 4 grams per day, oral divided 3 times a day after meal, may start 1 to 2 grams per day. Crohn's disease, 3 to 6 grams per day, oral divided 3 times a day after meal. Rheumatoid arthritis, enteric coated 3 grams per day, oral divided 3 times after meal, may start 0.5 to 1 gram per day. Can anyone hear me?
Yes.
Yes, go ahead.
I can hear you.
Okay, so for delayed release for rheumatoid arthritis, for other suggestion, dosing regimen, week one, 500 mg OD in evening, means total is 500 mg per day, and week two, 500 mg BD morning and evening, means total per day is 1 gram. Week three is 500 mg in the morning and 1000 mg in the evening, means total 1500 mg per day. And week four is 1000 mg BD morning and evening, means total 2 grams per day, administered in equally divided dose. For pediatric dosing, ulcerative colitis, less than 6 years, safety and efficacy not established. 6 years or older, initial dose is 40 to 60 mg per kg per day, oral divided each 4 or 8 hours after meal. Maintenance dose is 30 mg per kg per day, oral divided each 6 hours after meal. Juvenile rheumatoid delay release tablet, less than 6 years safety and efficacy not established, but 6 years or older, 30 to 50 mg per kg per day, oral divided twice a day after meal, not to exceed 2 grams per day. About mechanism of action. Sulfasalazine is a prodrug that is metabolized to active component sulfapyridine and 5-aminosalicylic acid, 5-ASA, mesalamine. Beneficial effects are predominantly from the anti-inflammatory properties of 5-ASA, which inhibit low cortin synthesis and lipoxygenase. And also, sulfasalazine metabolized by intestinal bacteria, resulting in the release of sulfapyridine and 5-aminosalicylic acid. The drug mechanism of action may relate to its effect on prostaglandin synthesis or interference with arginic acid metabolism by the lipoxygenase pathway. Pharmacokinetic absorption bioavailability is less than 50% of parent drug, 60% sulfapyridine, 10 to 30% 5-aminosalicylic acid. Peak plasma time 6 hours to 10 hours sulfapyridine and 5-aminosalicylic acid. Peak plasma concentration 6 mg per ml. Distribution. The volume of distribution is 7.5 liter. Protein bound is more than 99% to albumin, 70% sulfapyridine. Metabolized, approximately 90% of sulfasalazine is converted by colon bacteria into its active components, sulfapyridine and mesalamine. Excretion, urine is systemically absorbed sulfapyridine and 5-aminosalicylic acid and feces majority of 5-aminosalicylic acid. Elimination, half-life is 10.4 to 14.8 hours, sulfapyridine, and renal clearance is 37%. Medical uses. Sulfasalazine is used in the treatment of inflammatory bowel disease, including ulcerative colitis and Crohn's disease. It is also indicated for use in rheumatoid arthritis and use in other type of inflammatory arthritis, example, psoriatic arthritis and reactive arthritis. Sulfasalazine is used to treat ulcerative colitis and decrease the frequency of ulcerative attack and will not cure ulcerative colitis, but it can reduce the number of attacks you have. Sulfasalazine is also used to treat rheumatoid arthritis in children and adults, but it is usually not given to children under 2 years of age. Interaction, there is contraindicated. Ketorolac is cause increased toxicity. Ketorolac in cause increased toxicity. Serious use alternative, deferi prone cause increased toxicity. Methotrexate, sulfasalazine and methotrexate, both of them, they are first line treatment for for rheumatoid arthritis, okay, and using these two both together, sulfasalazine increased level of methotrexate by decreasing renal clearance. Sulfasalazine increased level of Pemetrex by an specific interaction mechanism. And also there is pexidartinib, both increase other, which is cause phototoxicity. And pertomanid cause increased toxicity of the other by other, which is cause hepatotoxicity. And adverse reaction, more than 10% anorexia, which is loss of appetite, 33%, headache, 33%, nausea, vomiting, 33%, gastric distress, 33%, and less than 1% skin rash, fever, urticaria, then pruritus, and hemolytic anemia. And pregnancy and lactation. For lactation, excreted into human breast milk, caution with breastfeeding. Some report of baby stool or diarrhea in human milk feed infants of mother taking sulfasalazine. For pregnancy, pregnancy category B and D is used for prolonged period or near term, increased potential for kidney terrors in the newborn baby. Kidney terrors means those newborn baby, they have a high level of bilirubin in jaundice, okay? It cause brain damage, which is lead to hearing loss or movement disorder. Oral sulfasalazine inhibit the absorption and metabolism of folic acid, which may interfere with folic acid sublimation and protection from neural tube defects. There are no adequate and well-controlled study of sulfasalazine in pregnant women. Reproduction study have been performed in rats and rabbits at doses up to 6 times the human maintenance dose of 2 grams per day based on body surface area, and have revealed no evidence of impaired female fertility or harm to fetus due to sulfasalazine. And patient counseling, we have to take this medicine by mouth after meal with full glass of water. Don't crush, break, or chew the tablets. Because patients should take this medicine for long term, this medication can have side effect range from mild to serious. Then patients should drink plenty of fluid while on therapy and avoid taking the drug on an empty stomach or with antacid. Drink extra fluid, then you will pass more urine while you are using sulfasalazine, and this may help prevent kidney problems. Because one of the side effects for the sulfasalazine can decrease or no urination. Sulfasalazine may occasionally cause kidney problem, and combining it with other medicine that can also affect the kidney and may increase the risk. Don't stop using any medication without first talking to your doctor. If you miss a dose, take the medicine as soon as you can, but skip the medicine, skip the missed dose if it is almost time for your next dose. Thank you. If you have any question, you can ask me. Hello?
In adverse effects.
Yeah.
Okay, Sharad, you carry. No, you carry. In adverse effects, you have to include vasculitis, Dress syndrome, then lupus like diseases. Like, it causes more adverse effect in rheumatoid arthritis patients. Like, they'll be on sulfasalazine. No. I think it's very less you have included in adverse effect.
The more adverse.
Your voice is breaking.
You want me to tell you another adverse effect or what? I know more adverse effects.
No, few of these adverse effects are not included, she is saying. Go to the adverse effect slide.
Yes, sir.
So she is telling that lupus-like reactions and
Dress syndrome, vasculitis. So many are there. Hepatitis. So many adverse effects.
I think so. This is adverse effects is from non-frequency, and only she mentioned less than 10% or more than 1%.
Most commonly, patients who are taking like rheumatoid arthritis patients who are on sulfasalazine will experience this adverse effect.
And do you know the frequency?
But I have seen many sulfa drugs. I have seen many Dress syndrome, vasculitis, mostly like vasculitis I have seen, than hepatitis toxicity.
Micropopular.
I found this
In
Medscape, and also there is adverse effect like little or no urination, okay, or urine looks foamy, the eyes swelling in ankle or feet, weight gain, and stomach pain, upper right side, and jaundice, and all of this. I didn't address what you are saying. That's why I didn't mention it.
See, because this causes photosensitivity reactions. If the person is taking this drug, going to the sunlight may cause these reactions.
Yeah, and patient minimum should take this tablet for 3 months, and after 4 to 8 weeks, it will show if it's affecting or getting any ADR. But those ADR period told me there, I didn't find it. So that's why this is whatever I found. It.
Since like sulfa allergy is more common, I just said to include all that. That's
also it. Cause, tell me, Robina.
Also causes GI intolerance, this sulfasalazine. So we have to start at low dose, as you said, like first 1 to 2 grams we have to start.
See, they say
this. Tolerating, again we have to decrease to 50%.
About
Rubena, is that Rubena?
Yeah.
Is that the reason it is given after meal?
Yeah, maybe because of that is the reason, because it causes severe GI intolerance. And if they have severe intolerance, then we have to stop it for like 1 week and again reinitiate with low dose.
And if they have sulfa allergy also, we will not prefer sulfa allergy.
About increasing doses.
They will do the desensitization, no, if there is a sulfa allergy.
Have allergy to sulfa, they should not take.
You have to know about the desensitization also.
Sir, whatever I study about increasing doses, they say because sulfa allergy cause a stomach upset. Okay, that's why doctors should increase doses slowly, depend on the patient medical history and all of it. They didn't say for all the patients. They said it depends to the patient. And they will start with 500 mg like this. If they have any like a gastrointestinal problem like this. Otherwise, it is whatever I found out in Micromedics and in Medescape and drugs.com and remaining website.
Yeah, it's contraindicated in intestinal obstruction, in urinary obstruction.
Okay.
Drug interactions you have added, huh?
She have added, sir.
Maryam, can you open this pharmacokinetic slide? So you had written sulfapyridine, no? Like what is the difference between sulfasalazine and sulfapyridine here?
The sulfasalazine structure is sulfonamide, which is sulfapyridine, and 5-aminosalicylamine. Okay. And sulfapyridine doesn't have any treatment action in the disease. That's because the sulfasalazine drugs, inactive drugs, acid to convert active drug to active drugs, and it will be rapidly absorbed in colon and all of this. Wait, I will. Did you get your answer, or you want me to explain more?
Your voice was not audible properly.
Okay,
it was breaking.
Now my voice is good?
Yeah.
Okay, see, the chemical structure of sulfasalazine, okay, is 5-aminosalicylic acid and sulfonamide, which is sulfapyridine, okay? And sulfapyridine is absorbed rapidly in the colon, okay? Acetylated in the liver, excreted in the urine, and no treatment action in the disease, okay?
Okay, you mean sulfapyridine is the metabolite of sulfasalazine?
Because sulfasalazine
is... It's pro-drug. Sulfasalazine is a prodrug, it will be converted into active form, that is sulfapyridine.
Yes.
Okay, active form is sulfapyridine.
Yeah, active form is sulfapyridine. The action is mainly due to sulfapyridine.
Your voice is breaking, Maryam. You need to be in good network.
Sir, still my voice is breaking because for all of your voice is good for me.
Yeah, now it's clear.
Okay.
All the adverse effects are due to sulfapyridine only.
Yeah, sulfapyridine mostly.
See, whatever it is there, because it is there, the metabolites, no, we will not tell that because, yes, actually it is because of sulfapyridine, but the drug is sulfasalazine, so we'll include into that only. One more thing, like less than 6 years in children's safety is not, what happens if it is used? What is the problem?
Sir, you know, more than the children, you know, that they born, okay, may they suffer jaundice, high level of bilirubin, okay? And if they take this medicine, okay, or the mother is taking and have breastfeeding, maybe it caused the brain damage, which is caused to hair losing and also movement disorder. Whatever I found out.
No, less than 6 years of age in children.
Yeah, because
it's a prodrug, no, maybe because of hepatic, like complete formation in that age.
I can't
see. Like in less than 6 years, when it comes, liver might not be completely formed since it's a prodrug. The complete active ingredient might not be, it might not get metabolized into active ingredient, is what I was thinking. In less than 6 years. Of
age. Yeah, also, I think you are right. I'm not sure, but I can't find out and let you know. But whatever the second said, also, I think is not wrong.
Okay, any other questions?
Sir, in metabolism, he has written 90% of sulfasalazine is converted by colon bacteria into its active compound. Like, if the patient is on any gut antibiotic previously and if we give sulfasalazine, it will be affected. We have to monitor that.
If the patient is in any antibiotic, it should not take the sulfasalazine.
See, that's the thing. I think a broad spectrum antibiotic will inhibit the conversion of sulfasalazine because colon bacteria will be lost.
It is contraindicated.
I know those people, they're using sulfonamide antibiotics, okay? They should, they have allergic or they are using like sulfonamide antibiotics, okay, they should not take sulfasalazine.
Okay, thank you, Maryam. Good presentation, okay. Who's next?
You can stop the recording.